हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शिक्षा मंत्रा वंस अगेन। टुडे इन शिक्षा मंत्रा आई हैव टेकन अ डिसीजन एंड व्हाट्स दैट डिसीजन? दिस वुड बी एन अनकट वीडियो टुडे, अनएडिटेड वीडियो। व्हाई? बिकॉज व्हेन वी एडिट अ वीडियो, व्हेन वी मेक समथिंग डिफरेंट विद दिस, एक्चुअली द स्पिरिट ऑफ teaching has been marred. So I have decided that from now on there will be all uncut video about teaching, learning, education, and obviously what? Yes, you know this, obviously about promotion of different hobbies. And in that trial we are today here with a very very important chapter for English grammar, and this is verbs and verbals. Yes dear friends, today we are going to discuss verbs and verbals and also how they work, what they make and why to learn them. So stay tuned with Shiksha Mantra to learn the tips and tricks of verbs and verbals. Let's begin our discussion. So let's learn verb first. Yes dear friends, you tell me, what's there to learn about verbs? We already know a lot of it. We already know what is a verb, how it works, what functions is had, and also what role it plays in our English constructions. So these are not my points today. Rather, today I would discuss something else. I would discuss how a verb is used in a different color. Yes, verbs are not always action verbs. Sometimes they are actually used for something else. And what's that? That would be our way for learning a verb in a different color. Yes, I'm talking of verbals. Now, if you ask me, sir, what is verbal? Actually, if you follow the term verbal, that means they have some connection with verbs, but they are not verbs. Yes, dear friends, before we start, it's better to share a story with you. One day, I was walking through a forest. Yes, it was on the hills of Himalayas. It's already dark. I was walking alone, and even I didn't have a torch with me. It was getting really dark, and I was passing through a forest, and the path was very narrow, and it's totally covered with huge trees. Suddenly, I found two glowing eyes staring at me, as if these are two balls of fire. I was perplexed. I didn't know what to do, because the first thing that struck my head was, it must be a cheetah. There's every possibility of facing a cheetah in the forest of Himalayas. So I stopped. I looked at the glaring eyes. I was trying to take a decision, but actually I was so perplexed that I couldn't decide what to do. Just then, there comes a meow. Yes, a mewing of a cat. And finally, I was relieved. I found out, oh, these glaring eyes aren't of a cheetah. Rather, she's its aunt. It's a cat. So a glaring eyes doesn't mean it's a tiger. It might be a cat as well. So a verb comes with a glaring eyes. Always it speaks large and loud. Here I am. Look at me. I'm here. I'm to control the sentence. But sometimes they come in disguise. With the glaring eyes, they don't roar. Rather, they muse. And the cheetah becomes the cat, verb becomes verbals. So that's the story of a verb and verbals. But how are they related? Yes, for this would have to get some examples. Okay, I'm coming to the examples, but before this I would share something else. Why a verb is named as verbals? There must be something that makes our sentences use something else instead of a verb. Now this story is again related to another very typical uses of English grammar. What? You know, the same word can be used in different parts of speech in English grammar, and the uses of the same word in different parts of speech is the trick to use English sentences in a very colorful way, and that's we do most of the time in producing an English sentence, and the verb also is no exception. For verbs too, we use the verbs in some different ways. Sometimes a verb is used like a noun. Sometimes a verb is used like an adjective. But there, the force of the verbs remain intact. The glaring eyes of the cheetah. The eyes remain, but not the roar. That means the verb remains, its verbal force remains, but it is not used as an action word. Rather, this is used for the purpose of naming or for the purpose of describing a name. So a verb is used with the force of a verb, still it is used as either a noun or an adjective, and verb lost its status. The cheetah lost its status and becomes a cat. The verbs lost its status and the verb becomes verbal. Yes, dear friends, there lies the difference between verbs and verbals. A verbals doesn't talk of an action. It relates an action, but it's used either for the purpose of naming or for the purpose of describing. That means the verb becomes nouns or adjectives and we call it verbal. That's it. If you remember this, you aren't going to miss verbals again. So now it's time for some example. How to make it. Suppose here two sentences are produced. What are the sentences? He makes doll. Making dolls, he earns some money. So two sentences I have given. He makes dolls. And the second sentence, making dolls, he earns some money. Now here, in both the sentences, you would find make. In the first sentence, he makes doll, make is used as a verb. Why? Because it simply speaks of an action. So it's an action word and this is a verb, there's no alternative. But if you consider the second sentence, making dolls, he earns some money. Here earns is the verb and what's making? It names the action. It names the action. What he does for producing some dolls to earn some money. And there lies the difference here. Making is not a verb, it's a verbal. That's it. So this is how you can find out the verbs and the verbals in a sentence. But remember, dear friends, when there's ing, most of the time we make mistakes. This for continuous, what we consider? We consider verb plus ing with be verbs, that is continuous. Verb plus ing with have or has or been, continuous. But this is not the fact. You must remember, when we put ing after a verb and we use it for continuous sentences, here this is not a verb, rather a verbal. Here this is present participle. And don't consider it as a verb, rather is making. is playing, is going. Together, this phrase is the verb, but not playing, making, going. They are verbals, they are participle. So, if you try to find out what are the types of verbals, you'd find three of them. What are they? Infinitive, gerund, participle. Sometimes it's considered as infinitive participles, gerunds. Yes, dear friends, three different types of verbals are there: infinitives, participles, gerund. And we are going to discuss each of them, infinitive, participle, and gerund, separately in our next videos. So stay till tune to our channel. We are going to discuss a lot about many interesting thing of English grammar. So we are coming back very soon with a fresh video of verbals, specifically infinitives. So stay glued, stay tuned, subscribe, like, and share the video if you really like this. We are returning soon with a fresh video. Until then, bye bye.